We'll be right back. Thank you. What? Thank you. Yo, what's up, guys? We got a rolling deep, deathless, low percent run here. Yeah, actually, nice. This took like 2 or 3 days. And that was like the goal I set for myself yesterday. I just kind of thought, yeah, a deathless run would be cool. Like sub 130 would be really sweet, but just a deathless run would be sweet. I almost got both at the same time, but some parts of the run were just, I mean, as you'd expect from someone not practicing this at all, some of the parts were just really awful. And the light world was complete shit too, unfortunately. Like, Eastern, I think that was a 1033, that's pretty good. Then a 6-cycle Lamo and a really terrible Hera. That might be 7 cycles, actually. Then I got 2 blue balls. Same as the PB. But I fell twice before getting to Aghanim. So that was like 7 seconds. Because the first time it was like trying to do the dash up, and then the second time it just fell like right away. Yeah, I mean, the rest is whatever. I'm not, like, worried about it or anything. Like I said, just a deathless run would have been sweet. I didn't actually think I was gonna do it, though. Like, I was gonna take a run, like, with a death or two or something like that. Like, some low 130, 131, 32, 33 time. And just leave it at that until, you know, if I want to get, like, sub 130 in this category or something. Yeah, I feel like just getting a deathless run is, like, just asking enough. I almost feel like the time is barely relevant. It's just like, did you die? No. Okay, your run's good. Did you die? Yes. Okay, you should keep going until you don't die. It's like, the time is almost irrelevant. Until you're in, like, the top, I don't know, 4, I guess, top 5. Yeah, the thing with Gen was, like, I got really horrible RNG, and then phase 4 was just even more horrible. He kept warping to the top right, like, every time I could light the torch again. That's really, really bad when you have the lantern. With FireEye, you can deal with that, but not with the lantern. I think my gold is pretty good too, because like I remember getting the good phase 2 RNG and really good phase 4 RNG as well. I was barely, I barely had to delay any spins at all. But I don't really know times for this category much. The deathless run is really sick, though. I'm pretty proud of that. I don't think this even would have been sub 130 if Ganon was better anyway. Let's see, what did I lose? Like 37? 38? Yeah, I lost 38. Yeah, it could have been close, but the Ganon RNG seems like a hell of a lot to ask for. Like, you got the whole run, which has enough RNG to ask for, and then you kind of need Ganon to go like top right or middle right. They get the double spins in the first two phases. Phase four, you don't want them to go top right at all. That's like, that's really asking a lot. I mean, I didn't even mention warps. I didn't even put warps in that equation. So. How would I rank the speed games I currently play according to how good they are to speedrun? Let me take a look here at what games I got. So, let's see. Alright, I'm gonna have to think for a second. So, let's go from worst to best. The worst might be Super Valus 4, and that's because the hitboxes are really wonky, and the final boss, Gallagher, is nearly unhittable. He has a bunch of different RNGs that he does that cost numerous seconds, and every single one makes him unhittable, and the only way you can hit him is when he just jumps in the air. And that's like, I mean, there's nothing much worse in a speed game when there's like a final boss like that, or even just a boss in general. That's like just about invincible and has RNG elements to it, and like, it's so easy to lose a bunch of time, and then, you know, you can get a really mediocre executed run before that and then get got RNG and, you know, not be able to beat that. That makes it pretty shitty, but the rest of the game is really great. I'm not factoring in like soundtracks or anything. I'm strictly going, you know, with strats and like, I guess looking at the speed game as it is at my level right now. That's what I'm going by the way. I mean, Road Rash 64 is casual, so I'm not counting that. I don't even know where to put that, because I don't really even know anything about actually speedrunning the game. It's just a really fun, casual, quote-unquote, speedrun to do. Let's see. Diddy Kong Racing is gonna have to go next because of the cutscene skips. Basically, to put it shortly, you have 39 tracks to race in the game, and at the end of each one of those tracks, there is a one-frame window where you can press pause right at the end of the race, on the final frame of the race, and if you do that correctly, you can go back to the lobby without playing the winning cutscene of you winning the race, and that's like 6 seconds apiece. And if you're doing any percent, if you miss one, you know, it's 20 seconds. The first one's 20 seconds, and then, you know, 6 seconds apiece after that. It's got the wrong warps, which can significantly differentiate routes and just timings, and it can just make your time fluctuate all over the place, and it's just a mess to deal with. You know, any percent has the TT Stomp in Future Funland, which, you know, don't even get me started on that. All Trophy Races is a really legit category, though, and even that category, like, the enemies can put down random oil slicks, or like, just messing up is so frustrating because they've optimized it so much. But also, like, the physics of the game is really, it just feels really unfair sometimes. Like, you can be holding a direction, and TT will just start going in the other direction, or, you know, something feels right, and you just go into the wall, or something like that. I think if you're not a top player of the game, it's really, really fun, though. Like, before I was getting, like, 157, maybe 158 and lower, and 100%, it was, like, fun as hell to me, especially in, like, the 220 range. Like, I remember that might be, at that time, like, the most fun I had with a speed game. Could be. Next up, we got Link to the Past. There's a lot of... Well, Aghanim. I can just start with that. Aghanim and Aghanim 2 and Ganon and... Well, Lanmola and Muldorm. And there's just a whole lot of fluctuation of RNG that can really affect your time in this game. And, like, you really, really have to break this game down to understand it. And even I'm not, like, as long as I've played the game, I'm still not, you know, confident that I understand a whole lot about the game. Maybe I understand a good amount, or a great amount, in the No Major Glitches category specifically, but game in general, I don't know. Yeah, there's just a whole lot that can go wrong in Link to the Past, and it's gonna go wrong all the time. You know, every boss has fluctuations in seconds, and, you know, they're difficult too. It's really easy to die, really easy to make mistakes, and really easy for everything to add up. And it's really hard to figure out what you're doing wrong sometimes. Like, you'll look at the players better than you, you wonder exactly what's happening. Even though I think I figured that part out at this point. Just really, I mean, it's pretty much what Zelna said every time. Consistency and not making mistakes. That's pretty much, you know, the top two right there. And then the last two I got is Super Castlevania 4 and Aladdin. And the next one, absolutely Super Castlevania 4. This one is, I mean, where do I even start? It's like, it's just as much bullshit as the rest. It's just, the other games are more difficult. That's the only reason why this one is second to best, even though I don't consider it best at all. It's complete bullshit. The game's complete bullshit with RNG and, you know, trying to get a good time and trying to execute well and, just like Link to the Past, try to not make mistakes. You know, the optimization is really insane at this point. And then the best one, for sure, is Disney's Aladdin on Super Nintendo. In my opinion, like, I know, like, general... Like, speedrunning is really big nowadays, and I know there's probably a big majority of people that, like, wonder, or, like, they watch speedruns and they want to do it themselves, but they, like, they don't know what to play, I guess, or something. I think that's how it goes. Like, with me, like, I kind of, like, how do I even say it? Like, I kind of morphed into... speedrunning instead of, like, instantly finding it and, like, ooh, where's, you know, what's a game I can play or something like that. Like there was part of that in how I got into it, but, like, mostly I was just playing Castlevania 4 to try to not get a game overrun or anything, and, like, I just kind of, like, eventually just morphed into it. I just found out about it and stuff. But, with Aladdin, that's, like, I would say Disney's Aladdin is, like, the game to pick up if you don't know what to speedrun and you don't want something bullshit difficult. and you want something really fun, a pretty short game, pretty simple platforming, pretty simple mechanics. Heavily optimized, though. It is a really heavily optimized game. Getting a top time in that is, you know, you gotta take a lot of time to do that. The only downside to it, if you really care about the cape mashing, you know, you're gonna really wear your fingers out with that. Really wear out your hand. Because whenever you press the cape, you pump forward a pixel. So you have to abuse that as much as you can. And then the final two bosses of the game have some RNG element. But you can actually take a death in an auto-scroller and do like two certain actions. And if you do that correctly, you'll always get the good Jafar RNG. It costs, like, you're wasting 3.5 seconds on the death for an 8-second RNG. So, you could do that. I mean, the game even has that. Like, you can make the game essentially RNG-free if you want to. And outside of those two bosses, there's next to no RNG in the game. So, it's a hell of a lot of fun to play. I'm surprised more people don't play it. Maybe it's not known or something. But that's like, that's the game that I would fully recommend to pick up to like that minority of people that watch speedruns and want to do it themselves and don't know what game to pick up. I would wholeheartedly say Disney's Aladdin for Super Nintendo. I even got a tutorial for it. And some strat videos and stuff. What about Super Metroid? Well, like, I don't speedrun that seriously, but, I mean, I would have to imagine if you were at a high level with that game, that would probably... Wait, what's here? Oh, yeah, that would be the worst game. Of all these, that would go below Super Valis 4. So yeah, in order of best speed games that I run to worst, I would go Aladdin, Super Castlevania 4, Zelda, A Link to the Past, Diddy Kong Racing, Super Valis 4. And if you want to throw Super Metroid down there for the absolute worst, then... Well, because, like, you have ammo counts to deal with, and you have fucking Fantoon and Ridley, and, you know, you have Torian and all that, like... Let me put it this way. I can perfectly use 2Cat as the example here. 2Cat played Super Metroid for years. Has a good time. Played Super Castlevania 4 for 2-3 months. Is already 4 seconds behind Fury's Paw. So, you know, I can just leave it at that. That's not to say anyone can pick up Super Castlevania 4 and get a 31 and... you know, 2 to 3 months, but, you know.